So basically, a commercial fertiliser is like your ready-mix Ribena. Please do not drink your DIY fertiliser. If you're over in the USA, let me introduce you to the awesome drink Ribena. It's an awesome blackcurrant cordial that us Brits love. It's rich, refreshing, and it reminds me of a hot summer's day coming inside for a glass of the good stuff. And I guess our parents loved it too. For a couple of quid, you could keep us happy for a few months instead of splashing out on overpriced cans of fizzy drink. And why did it last so long? Well, because it's a cordial. 95% of the drink comes straight from the tap. More on that Ribena analogy later, but seen through this lens, you're going to very quickly understand why commercial aquarium fertilisers are a rather unnecessary expense. And better still, I'll show you a secret to adapt your DIY fertiliser for your specific water quality and the dosing regime you intend to follow. So let's get down to it. Here's everything you need to know about DIY aquarium fertiliser. First up, what is a commercial aquarium fertiliser? Probably the most common product you're going to come across is an all-in-one solution that contains both macro and micronutrients. Your macronutrients are the three essential ingredients for plant growth: nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. These are often abbreviated by their chemical elements and simply called NPK. The micronutrients are all the other nutrients which your plants benefit from, but generally require in smaller quantities. These are things such as iron, manganese, and magnesium. Often you will even have trace amounts of these nutrients within your tap water. More on that later. But in addition to these macro and micronutrients, your commercial all-in-one fertilizer consists of water. A lot of water. Now, it's necessary because it allows all the nutrients which are typically available as dry salts to be dissolved into a solution that is then more easily usable in the aquarium. But water is also heavy, and containing it requires a decent quality container. These things combine to produce a cost for the consumer. Basically, you're purchasing a pre-mixed Ribena purely for convenience, but it's not even that difficult to make up your own. So how do you make up your own? Well, plenty of companies exist that specialise in supplying aquarium dry salts. Here in the UK, for example, we have a company called Aquarium Plant Food, which sells dry salt starter kits for £20, which will allow you to make 8 litres of fertiliser. To put that in perspective, I was previously using TNC Complete, and 8 litres would set me back £120. But I don't think we can stop just there with me recommending a starter kit and leaving you to it. Whilst their recommended recipes would be a great start, if you really want to reap the benefits of dry salts, then I highly recommend exploring the awesome IFC Aquarium Fertilizer Calculator, available via the UK Aquatic Plant Society forum. First up, a huge thanks to Zeus and Hanneman, who created this calculator, keep it regularly updated, and were kind enough to let me showcase it in this video. Their contributions to the UKAPS forum is invaluable. And just in general, if you ever need any advice, that forum is the best, in my opinion. I'll of course leave links for everything in the video description. So the IFC Aquarium Fertilizer Calculator is an Excel spreadsheet that you can download, plug in the data about your tanks and tap water quality, and then it will give you precise measurements about how to make up a DIY fertilizer that is appropriate for your specific situation. For example, let's say that you want to do a daily estimative index dosing on a 200 litre aquarium. You have a 500ml container, and you find it convenient to dose with a 3ml pipette. This calculator will tell you precisely how much of each dry salt you need to add in order to reach the recommended dosage for macro and micronutrients and adapt the ratio to work for your desired dosing regime. You can also clone existing fertilizers, matching the precise ratios of a commercial fertilizer. So if you're afraid to switch because you have great results for a particular brand, you can be pretty reassured that this calculator will also allow you to make a near identical product for a fraction of the price. The calculator also has lots of safeguards, so it won't let you accidentally create a ratio that won't fully dissolve, it will highlight when your dosing regime is going to mean storing your mixed solution for too long, and it reminds you about adding reducing agents to stop any dry salts from reacting with one another. Now, I'm imagining at this stage that it's all sounding a bit much, so let's return to our bottle of Ribena. I promise you, the DIY process is not asking you to pick the blackcurrants, clean them, mash them, boil them up, sweeten it, preserve it, and bottle it. All this process is asking is that you add the water at the end. So let me explain how I use this calculator to make my own DIY fertilizer. At the bottom of the sheet, you will see multiple tabs. The main ones I'll talk you through are the tank and dosing tab, the target calculator tab, and the core settings tab. The first tank and dosing tab is where you enter details of your aquarium size, desired dosing regime, and the volume of the container you intend to mix everything in. There is an option to add multiple tanks to the database and create completely custom ratios for each tank. And if you were doing different dosing regimes, this would certainly make sense. However, in my case, I want to do estimative index in each tank, so I combine the total water volume, said I intended to dose 24 mL daily, and then work this out proportionate to the tank size afterwards. So in my case, my 210 litres of water is made up of one 70 litre tank, two 55 litre tanks, and one 30 litre tank, which worked out around 8 mL, 6 mL, and 4 mL daily doses proportionately. If you just have one tank, this won't be an issue, but I definitely found it easier to work with one calculation for my total water volume and do the proportionate dosage calculations afterwards. So once you've entered details about your tank, you are onto the calculator tabs. But before we do that, here's a little bonus tip. If you're able to get a water quality report from your water company, then before you start using the calculator, I would advise you head to the Core Settings tab. Here you can enter the milligram values of the nitrate, phosphate, and potassium already found in your water. In my case, I had almost 6 milligrams per litre of nitrate and phosphate coming out of my tap. By entering this in the Core Settings first, the calculator will now take this into account when making up your DIY recipe. So now we can go back to the calculator tabs. For your purposes, the only calculator you need to worry about is the target calculator. The other two are aimed at more advanced users and people making up their own trace mixes. So the target calculator probably looks a bit overwhelming to begin with. You've got lots of compound names and a few different options to contend with. So I'll try and take you through what I think is the simplest approach of cloning either a commercial product or a popular dosing regime, i.e. making your own Ribena. First, select yes for option 1, and then select what product or regime you would like to clone at option 2. For me, I select EI dosing full because I dose all of my tanks daily with the estimative index with a weekly 50% water change, but you might prefer to pick a product you know has worked well in the past. Whatever you select, it will adjust the target parts per million figures accordingly and highlight this at section 4. Now, section 5 is where it starts to look complicated, so let me just scroll over this a little and explain what you are trying to achieve. The grand total column will show the percentage of your nutrient target that has been achieved. So as you start to populate the compound ratios in the blue column, you will start to see this increase, and you are aiming to get to 100% of your target. If you start to play about with the blue ratio column, you will notice that the dry salts contain a variety of macro elements which will start to appear in the greyed out columns on the right. For example, for me, potassium nitrate is contributing all of my nitrate requirements, but not quite all of my potassium requirements. The reason there are lots of compounds listed is because there are numerous ways that you can achieve the required macronutrient levels. The blue column is a ratio column, and if you purchase a starter kit, then it is most likely that you are just going to use one compound for each section. Let's take my recipe as an example. I purchased a starter kit of potassium nitrate, potassium phosphate, and magnesium sulfate, and I also purchased some monopotassium phosphate separately. So all of my nitrate comes from the potassium nitrate, all of my phosphorus comes from the monopotassium phosphate, and my potassium comes from a combination of my potassium nitrate, monopotassium phosphate, and potassium sulfate. So once you've indicated the ratio of each compound and your grand totals are equaling 100%, you can now refer to the container column to find out how many grams of each dry salt to add to your container. This will adjust according to your container size and dosing regime and be a bespoke measurement for the specific situation that you outlined in the tank and dosing tab, including the existing compounds identified in your water report. Further down this section, you have the same calculator for your trace elements. The important thing to achieve here is 100% of your iron target. For my recipe, I'm using the ready-mix trace element salts that came with my starter kit from Aquarium Plant Foods UK. But there's a number of different mixes plugged into the calculator, including straight-up chelated iron. Again, whatever ratio you go with, this will give you an indication of how many grams to add into your mix in the container column. So we're almost ready to mix our fertilizer. Just one very important thing to point out first. What the calculator has just given you is a calculation for an all-in-one fertilizer with your macro and micro elements. The reason a starter kit will often come with instructions to make these up separately is because if you don't add a buffer, then the iron and phosphate can combine to become useless to your aquarium plants. To stop this from happening, it's important that you add a small quantity of ascorbic acid and potassium sorbate to your container before adding the other salts. This will lower the pH and stop this reaction from occurring. Fantastically, the calculator will also tell you how much of these two reducing agents to add to your container in the summary information at the top. For me, I needed to add 1 gram ascorbic acid and 0.4 grams of potassium sorbate. These can be purchased really easily online from places like Aquarium Plant Foods or indeed from eBay. Okay, so the tricky part is over. You've added in your ratios and now you know how much of each ingredient to add to make up a fertilizer. Make sure you save the spreadsheet for future reference and you may even want to type up your recipe. But essentially, you now have your cordial ready for mixing with water. So the final topic is water. Some people recommend deionized water and some people say you can get away with simply boiling water and cooling it back down. The potential issue is contaminants in the water clouding your mix or making it go off. I think ultimately it depends on how long your dosing regime will make your mix last. My recipe is designed to last just 6 weeks and I've never had any issues using cooled down boiled water. However, I'm just about to try deionized water for the first time, so I'll pin a comment if I notice any differences. And with all that out of the way, it truly is incredibly straightforward from this point on. Measure out your dry salts, add them to the container, and top up with water. Job done. You can now dose your tank according to whichever regime you decided upon, and making up a new solution will take you just a few minutes every month or so. I'd say the initial time and effort is well worth the years of cost saving you're now going to experience. And just think about all the awesome plants and fish you can buy with that spare cash. So basically, a commercial fertilizer is like your ready-mix Ribena. Convenient if you're out and about and need a quick gulp of the good stuff, but you'll pay a premium for that convenience. Dry salts, on the other hand, are like your trusty bottle of concentrated cordial. It's cheap, it will last for ages, and when you make up a glass, it tastes exactly the same. Okay, so now just a disclaimer. I hope the Ribena analogy was useful, and hopefully this goes without saying, but please do not drink your DIY fertilizer. However, on a similar topic, if you want to see me eating fish food, you can click the bottom card. And probably of more relevance to this video, if you want to find out all about the estimative index, then click the top card. Take care, and I'll see you soon.
Cheers. That's really good.